Diane French Cole. They call her Mama D in New Orleans, the Seventh Ward.
Mama grew up with the realities of life and understanding that there were, you know, double standards. And not just from an American perspective, because as I mentioned, you know, she, half of her was pure Haitian, no enslavement.
I don't know what this is. And I don't really care. Mama brought you a point that y'all don't seem to be understanding. And that little girl, this district, the Morgan, you need to come get her. I stand before you with 20 years, one walk. None of us have been included in anything. Young man, you need to return your calls to Mr. Nord Director. Go look when you get back, baby. You got 2-3 calls for me here. I want the 501c3. None of that means anything to us. We are neighbors. We live in our neighborhood. If I had known y'all won't be so low down and dirty with the election, with 28,000 votes, we'd kick your butt all over the city. Know it's coming to here. You're not gonna keep doing this, making decisions by a few. And some of y'all told me you were just voting to get it on there so the public could address it. But when you got out there for it. We saw everything. It took us a long time to get from behind the screen on the bus, because it wasn't time. And you had the best practices for those who knew why we needed to stay behind the screen on the bus. Why y'all keep disrespecting these old people? When they come, y'all know you need to suspend something and let them say what they need to say. That's totally disrespectful. These are the people who are the reason why we've been able to survive in this city. And I understand some of y'all not knowing that because you ain't from here. But I want to tell you, this don't say nothing to us. What does this mean? Centers, athletics, summer camp, special programs, additional youth athletics programs, teen camp. I don't know what this is. Books and balls, movies in the park. It's obvious that you haven't talked to us. Ask Little North. Where's Surpass at? Where Miss Left? Call Little Surpass. See, man, that our children are dead.
We need you to bring your
remarks. I know what you need, and I'm telling you what I need, and I'm telling you I'm bringing it from my community.
Please bring your remarks to
the floor. And you need to understand this. If you don't stop me, how do you know what I was getting ready to say if I was ready to end what I was getting ready to say?
Miss Cole, please bring your remarks to the close of the time. Yeah. Period.
You know, you don't know, me and you already did this. You know, remember when you called?
I understand, and I'm asking you as respectfully as possible to abide by the
rules. No, you aren't. And I can understand that you haven't been here for 10 years. You don't know what we do and how we do it. So let's not play the dozens, bro. That ain't about that.
I don't care if you turn this off. That's what I'm saying. 2 minutes for our children.
Miss Cole, I have respectfully tried to ensure that everybody has the right to speak and wishes to speak. Every card has been called.
Yeah, 2 minutes about our children. You ain't talking about your children. The majority of children in New Orleans are not your children.
All right. We are going to, Mr. Conklin, I think that concludes our discussion on Nord. Unless you have any final comments that you or Ms. Duplessis or anybody else wishes to make.
They gave that lady 15 minutes to talk.
Mr. Coppins.
Thank you.
They gave the lady 15 minutes to talk.
We will have Charlotte Tarrant, who is the acting director of our health department, and she will give you an overview of the budget office.
It was just 30 seconds to transition our paperwork, which is a lot here. We're going to health department. Okay. The floor is yours.
Just gave the lady 15 minutes to talk. That's from the Winter Summer Fair.
What's happening? I'm on my way in there. Your mama in there? Oh, shit. That's Eddie, my brother from another, obviously. Mm-hmm. It's his mama.
For sure. Did you try to spell everything right?
Okay. Well, you can wait. Put that down. Let's go catch Miss R since she's on her way out, okay? I would like to do that, if you don't mind.
Yeah, she remembered too. She remembered too.
We got to come work on the house and just like, you know, give a nigga honest work, you know, like, because she saw I had my daughter. I ain't gonna lie, a couple of them times I was about to fall off, nigga. She don't even really know what she did, but I'm not trying to tell her, but she don't believe me. First time I was about to fall off, I am no re-up money, no nothing, no rent money, no nothing. She gave me a job where I made like
$900.
I just remember, wait, this is what I'm trying to ask you. It was a white house right there. Two stories. I don't know if it was you or your people.
That had been me.
Yeah, well, that was your house.
Nobody smoked weed, but like me.
Yeah, that was my house. All right. Yeah, I'm talking about way before she was born.
Yeah.
All right.
Yep.
You know, everything good, man?
I was going to see how long it took you to look over there.
All the issues related to Michael Howard. And now he's doing it with this question.
How you doing?
How you doing? How you been?
How you
doing?
Look, I'm doing a documentary.
Yeah, I'm doing.
I just found my life script, right? And so I want to take a couple pictures. Even though I ain't dressed, I still.
I need it.
Just a couple pictures.
What's going on?
Did you get my card?
This is
for me. That just works for us.
It's just amazing. I mean, just all
the love. So I was taught that you always, you know, bring that back.
Okay, okay.
So that might be why the other people love you too. Yeah, so you're, I guess I was really just trying to say, hey, we just out the blue loving you. I remember you used to say, you can take a plate if you ain't got enough, and you can pay me another time and all that. You remember that? So,
and you know, and I
keep
that
the 100.
I heard that a lot of guys wrote me from the penitentiary. I have no idea who he is, but that's what he said. He said they thank you for that. You know, you do things and you keep moving. You don't
that's
even think about it.
Let me tell you something. Right. I come in here.
Submit your comments now on
Many a day. And you know what? I try to always keep it 100 with you. When I had my money, I would just pay it. You remember, I would turn it down. But a couple of times, I remember getting them plates. You know? And that's, you know, that was, that's 100 when you don't just get successful and forget about
it. But you were successful with good luck because you always made sure your baby was okay. You be out there on the struggle. Car barely running, no air. But he did what he had to do.
Yeah, he always been like that.
And Kevin, she was in the car. In her little belly, then he'll walk in the shade, bring her up there, sit on the porch while he was trying to do the sign on the house.
Everyone walked up right in front of his face and said, damn, B the Barrage is cool. Where you get that at? He looked at me. I looked at him. Uh-oh. Yes, ma'am.
Daddy?
Yes.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
So Nikki just called me, and mom told her that I was down here. So now she's been told Granny and everybody that I don't even really know, so I'm not surprised anymore. But, yeah, I just wanted to tell you that.
Okay. I mean, look, I've told you that. You never...
It doesn't even really matter, but I just wanted to tell you that.
Well, this is what I want you to know. Like I taught you, you never have to lie to them. And they can't get mad at you for where I go and what I do. Nah, you know.
Yeah, like she was like, so if you're down here, then where are you at? Nikki was like, Nikki said that. And I just said, oh, I'm just running errands with my dad.
Was your mom on the phone too?
She was trying to connect her, but she waited too long.
I'm calling black people in New Orleans, right? And I'm trying to employ them up to $100 an hour sometimes, you feel me? And they don't want to handle me in a professional manner. So I'm calling, they ain't answering the phone.
I'll shoot them a text and say, I got somebody else, I'm all good. So then they get mad at me, you feel me?
I don't care what she speaks. She still needs to win that time.
Sir, help you, sir. Let her handle her business, and you just wait until we able to help you.
I can understand him, though. So what we need to do is file a formal complaint. All I said was I can understand the man. That's unpeaceful. I wasn't. Was I being unpeaceful?
There ain't nothing wrong with asking no questions.
Was I being unpeaceful though, ma'am? Because see, I've been recording since he started talking, so I just want to make sure
that's fine.
Okay.
But what I want to tell you,
I didn't do anything unpeaceful. I just said I agree with the brother.
And the gentleman, we just need the situation peaceful so we can wait on y'all.
Yes, ma'am.
And
what I'm asking you for the sake of my video was I being unpeaceful? Because I didn't think I was. I just said I agree with him.
This is the thing. When you make comments like that, it goes on and other people just like he
Well, we've been sitting in here for 2 hours and she getting a priority. In the office. Well, why is she going before?
We don't speak Spanish.
Why are you yelling? Why are you yelling? Why are you hollering? Because you call the police? That's why you hollering? Because you call the police, ma'am? There's no problem. Let me say this before we start, officer. I've been recording since the jump, all right?
Okay.
So I'm going to be able to prove everything I'm saying.
All right, so what's the problem?
This man just asked why that lady got to go ahead, and the lady over there said because she speaks Spanish. And the man said, well, I understand that, which I have him on video. He never acted crazy or nothing. I knew they was going to say he did. That's why I started recording, okay? All he asked was, why do we got to wait? And she get a priority because she speak a different language. Her number after hours. He is 36, mine 37. And we've been in here for a long time. Now, I want to let you know how I got out of hand. All that man did was express an objection, and they start hollering at him. I got it all on tape. She been hollering. The lady in the green wasn't really hollering. She just started hollering for nothing. I'm just telling you, though. Yeah, you sure did. I got it on video. I'm glad you didn't dispute that.
Several workers, and we're here to help you guys.
I understand that.
Do the English language.
I understand that. We was making a valid point. Right. We born and raised in New Orleans.
That's all that man did.
But he didn't do nothing for them to have to go call the police on him like she did. And that's why I made my video. I just want you to know that's how black men getting killed all over the world, Officer B. Enemy. That man didn't do nothing for the police to get called on him. I got it on video.
Understand.
That's ridiculous, though.
There are several English speaking workers that are here to help you guys.
Oh yeah, I understand what she was saying. We were saying that we from Louisiana and it shouldn't go like that. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna file a formal complaint since I have the video on documentation of how this lady handled you and then say, yeah, she so did and she don't have
to talk to me or you wanna talk
basically
to
me. Well, he's involved. She didn't call him on me, she called him
but
on him.
He's listening, you're not.
Yeah, I'm telling you what happened that I have on tape.
I understand you got your video evidence, and now that's fine and damn. Yeah. I'm telling you how the procedure works here. There are several English speakers.
Yeah, we know the procedure.
That help English
we know the procedure. What we're wondering is why you can't question the procedure without getting the police called on you. That's what we're wondering.
There are different ways of doing things. Just because I understand you've been sitting waiting, everybody in
Wait,
here.
Wait, you're not hearing me, sir. All the man did was question. Ask that lady right there. Ask this lady right here.
So if he
all the man
what
did
you
was question.
Tanya, no.
My point is, did the man do something? But wait, though,
man,
for real, though, did the man do something for her to go call the police
was
on
talking
him?
To her, what
See,
you
look,
have
the
to
lady
do?
Just said the man didn't do nothing for her the police to be called on him. Well, that's my
he's
point.
He's calm. You the one making the commotion.
I'm not making commotion. I'm trying to ask you. Can you understand what I'm saying?
Okay, what are you
the
saying?
The lady just admitted.
I'm
want to know why this lady ran in there and called the police, and this lady just admitted he didn't do nothing to get the police called on him. That's what I'm trying to figure out. That's what I'm trying to figure out.
So you ranting and raving and breaking out your video camera?
I'm not ranting and raving or nothing. I know what to expect. I started recording as soon as he spoke because I knew what she was going to do him.
What was she going to do?
What she did him.
Which was what?
Ran out there like it was a problem.
She didn't call the police
and all the man did.
You don't want back here ranting.
How she? Who she called the police on?
You just
want
a piece.
Look, miss. Look, miss. Who she called the police on?
You still missing the situation.
So I'm trying to figure out how you think. Wait. So I'm trying to ask you, sir.
This
is what I'm trying to ask you. How did we get to... Wait a minute. This is what I'm trying to ask you.
Do you understand what I'm saying?
Officer Benamy, I have to ask you this for documentation. You said the police was called on me?
I'm supposed,
is that what you just told me?
There was a problem back here. That's why I was
coming. Okay, so now you saying me, but see, I wasn't the problem.
You were the one that
I wasn't the problem, though.
You were the one that was like, okay, you may not have been a problem, but you were the one that
no,
was like.
No, what I did was I was responding to this lady yelling at me.
Was that you were the problem?
I was responding to this lady yelling at me. That's what I was doing. All I did was agree with the man. She went off and called the police. I said, I agree with him. No cussing, no fussing, no nothing. I got it on tape, man. I can't believe you in there doing black people like that, and you know we in here because we in trouble. Let's call the police on you because you asked a question, mister. I can't believe that. Yeah. You the thing, we was in there threatening somebody or something.
Sure.
You don't ask no questions, be quiet.
Can we all agree to kumbaya? Can we let the process take its course?
We wasn't never tripping, man. That's what I'm telling you.
We good. We good.
I got it on. Look, I'm going to show you. After this is all over and I know y'all, they ain't going to flip the script on me, I'm going to show you the video. We wasn't never tripping. Nobody wasn't cussing, fussing, nothing.
I'm about to show you the city. We're going to drive down through the heart of the city.
Piper, Kansas.
It's a suburb of Kansas City. Okay, so this is a picture made by a friend of mine's daughter. That's half Cardell, half Bear, because that's his nickname. You hear me? We have these shirts right now for $20. We got an appeal coming up. We're trying to get an innocent man free. A man that was a support system for his family and they need him out. Mm-hmm. This is the bag.
Absolutely.
Well, they won't let me in no jails since Cardell been in jail. They won't let Cardell get none of my letters. They all come back to me. Yeah. Yeah. I try to have other people write letters, they get them. He get their letters.
Oh,
look, get that on film. Anybody that's really trying to support him for real, real, they rejected our mail. We can't go visit him. I ain't never even been convicted of a felony. Never. Ever. At all. And I graduated from Delgado to be a private investigator. Had to go to Baton Rouge, get fingerprinted, and licensed and bonded by the state to be a private investigator. And I can't get in the jail or the penitentiary. At all. Most niggas will say that's a blessing. But I'm trying to get something done. And I can't get in.
Release Cardell here!
Release Cardell here!
What's
up,
bro? What's up? Release Corey Simpson!
Release Corey Simpson!
Release Corey Miller!
Release
Cardell
Hayes.
Release Corey Simpson. Release Corey Miller.
That's ridiculous, man. How they do that? You know how they do that? They do that because the ACLU or nobody else ain't gonna jump on it because ain't enough black people complaining about it. So they like, damn. You know, like, if you're going to fight and help your boy in the street, he got to swing first, right? Mm-hmm. Like, you know, if I watch you walk up and punch my partner, I help him, but he got to, you know, he got to stand his ground. And so ain't nobody seeing us standing our ground, and so people just doing what they want to do to us, and they praying on us. And I'm telling you, the state of Louisiana is denying me entrance into the penitentiaries, and the city of New Orleans denying me in the parish prison. To see these people without no, they can't substantiate it. They can't, it's not warranted. Go see my clients. I can't get in this jail. I can't get in no prison. I'm not a felon. And I'm bonded by the state. And can't get, keep getting refused to go see Cardell and Carter. That's illegal. Why can't I go? I'm not a felon or nothing. I mean, damn, this is what I mean by full equity for black people in New Orleans. That's bullshit. That's really bullshit, man. They denied my visit for this weekend. I'm thinking I'm going to the pen tomorrow, man.
Release Cardell Hayes.
Release Cardell Hayes.
Release Corey Simpson.
Release Corey Simpson.
Release Corey Miller.
Release Corey Miller.
You can't hide the truth.
Can't hide the truth.
Full equity for black people.
Black people.
In New Orleans.
In New Orleans.
In New Orleans.
Full equity.
Full equity.
For black people.
For black people.
In New Orleans.
In New Orleans.
Full equity.
Full equity.
For black people.
For black people.
In New Orleans.
In New Orleans.
You can't hide the truth.
You can't hide the truth.
Release Cardell Hayes.
Release Cardell Hayes.
Release Corey Miller.
Release Corey Miller.
Release Corey Simpson.
Release Corey Simpson.
Can't hide the truth.
I gotta do me a live today so I could, make sure everybody knows these are available.
Mm-hmm.
Then, you know, I'm feeling gracious today, so I'm gonna go ahead and give them some advice. I'm about to kill them today with the maroon polo shoes, you heard me? But look, this is why I really put this on there though, because I want y'all to know I'm not shallow or superficial. I put this on there because I think I paid what, $12 for these shoes?
Maybe.
Yeah, maybe. Mm-hmm. At Marshall's, feel me? Mm-hmm. And so, you know, I'm just trying to let them young cats know you can stay fly, you don't gotta go spend $1 million, you feel me?
Exactly.
I wanna tell you, in 1986, my dad took me overseas for about 3 or 4 weeks. And one of the places that we were fortunate enough to visit was Egypt. We actually bought this from the bazaar in Egypt.
Mm-hmm.
It was handmade. And this is papyrus or something.
Mm-hmm.
I believe I had to ask my dad if he could speak intelligently on it. And
it's hieroglyphics, papyrus.
Yes. And we paid a lot of money for that thing. And so I asked my dad, I said, if he don't leave me anything else, I want this picture, because I was there with him when we bought it.
Yes.
And that's a story.
Absolutely. My dad, the judgment scene.
Yeah. My daddy could tell you, though, what the exact story is. I forgot.
Pretty much.
I need to have him tell me again. But that's actually a story.
Mm-hmm.
Something about life and spirituality right there.
I watched this dude right here, Arab, buy this gas station, right?
Mm-hmm.
After he bought the gas station, then he added a chicken party. Like, that's a whole chicken party now.
Right.
Then he added the clothes store, player clothes. Who you think he's selling them to? Then he added the boost store. Who you think he's selling boost to? Feel me?
Yeah.
But let me tell you something. But then that's where reciprocity comes in.
Right.
Because, like, every time after that, I knew I couldn't make it even to him, you feel me?
Yeah.
But every time after that, I tried to, like, do whatever I could do. Like, I had, one day I came across a deep freeze, like a nice one. Right here, you know what I'm saying? Just little stuff like that.
Yeah, to show your appreciation.
Yeah, man. You have to.
Most definitely.
And I remember, she went back there and cleaned that thing, and then we put that one in there. You know what I mean?
Today, us went out there.
Yeah.
Yeah. How long did that thing last?
Probably
last
longer than that, you know.
Really?
It's
right.
Okay.
Might be
one of them still back there,
because
I've been having one back there for a long time.
Let me see.
The only reason I stayed here is because I had babies here, man.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I had to watch out for them. Had to do what you had to do. As soon as my youngest daughter that I didn't have custody of, as soon as she got grown, I burnt out. Because I had DD with me, I just took her with
me. Come, bro.
And my son, who you gonna meet today, he a G. Mm-hmm. He young, you know. He's still young and, you know, like a little puppet, you know, clumsily. Mm-hmm. But you could tell that he like me and he gonna be straight. He listens. So I know he gonna be straight.
For graduation. But it's a start. Oh, it's a nice car stereo. Huh?
I didn't bring my present.
You forgot your present for him? Well, we're coming back next week. Give it to him, give it to you, buddy.
Thank you. Ooh. Yeah, I'm about to be, hey. Wait, so when will you be back, though?
I'm gonna take you and show you Allen Fieldhouse.
Who is Allen Field?
Allen Fieldhouse is where the Jayhawks play. The Kansas basketball team.
Mm-hmm.
It'd be jumping. I only been in there the one game, but it'd be jumping. I watched a million of them on TV.
If our whole community operated, like if all the elders did like how you did, and just found them a couple to just help and bring up, and then, you know, be able to see that we learned from it and we did all right, you know, we'd be better off.
32, 34. Let me tell you what happened. See, the reason why we're going over this is because I want you to see the patterns. You start off, you say 2, 4, 6, 8, right?
Mm-hmm.
Then you say 10, right?
Mm-hmm.
Then you say 12, 14, 16, 18. Then you say 20, right? And then after 20, you see the pattern come again. 22, 24, 26, 28, 30. 32, 34, 36, 38, 40, 42, 44, 46, 48, 50. You see the pattern?
Mm-hmm.
So now count by twos for me to 40.
But look, how you know how many nines to write?
Five.
Okay, because it's 9 5 times, right? So this is 10 4 times. How many tens you gonna write?
Four.
Okay, and this is 7 times 6. 7 6 times. How many sevens you gonna write?
Two.
Okay, so I know you know that 9 times 5 is 45. Go ahead and write it there. You just showed me. And that's a good job. But this is what I want you to do now. I'm trying to teach you a fundamental issue that you're having. And so we have to go back to square one, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And so when you do this, I promise you, you'll be done with the problems with multiplication. I'm telling you, 5 times 8 is just really, they're asking you, what's 5 8 times, all right? Or you could go, what's 8 5 times? You know you can go backwards. Here you could go, what's 6 8 times?
I don't care. I was there when we bought that, and that picture mean the world to me. And I'm going to make sure that whatever one of my kids I give it to, understand why, you know, not it ain't because it's worth money, it's because I went with him,
right?
You know, when we bought that, and we looked at a whole bunch of different pictures before we bought, we just picked the first one we saw.
Mm-hmm.
You know, daddy picked one we really wanted, and he let us, you know, participate when we ain't had no money, you know.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you go spend $5,000-$10,000 on something, you ain't gonna let somebody participate.
Mm-hmm. Mm-mm, not at all.
Yeah, you know what? I ain't gonna lie to you. It also dawned on me, too. Last time I was sitting here looking at it, that it's probably worth way more than we paid for it now, too.
Mm-hmm.
appreciation.
Yeah, man, that's one of the reasons why I love my daddy. He showed me so much shit. He took me to, I've been to Memphis, where they, where all the stars and white people go to make their colognes and oils and stuff. Mm-hmm. They go get them.
Mm-hmm.
And when we were at Memphis, the gypsy we were talking to, because my daddy was looking for a fragrance for my stepmother, the gypsy we were talking to, she had just seen Elizabeth Taylor before us. And that fragrance that Elizabeth Taylor came out with,
mm-hmm.
she came out with right after we had been there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so we knew it was true.
Mm-hmm.
Man, like, look, for instance, let me tell you. You can't escape it. I try to think, well, I'm just going to go live over here and just don't be an activist no more, right? Don't happen like that. No matter where you go, as soon as you start trying to thrive as a black man.
They that, put the pressure on you.
Yeah, that hate comes.
That's when that pressure comes.
That hate,
well, the hate
coming.
Yeah.
Pressure, hate, whatever.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That's when it comes. And like, it's to the point now where I don't expect nothing different. When white people be nice, I be like, damn, for real? Because I'm expecting them to just, you know, do what the rest of them do. But you got to stay grounded out here spiritually, or, you know, and emotionally, or you'll be in trouble. Like, man, believe it or not, like, you know, I had to come see my grandkids, man.
Absolutely.
There's so much shit that happened on a daily basis out here that I'd just be like, fuck it. I want to quit just living. You know what I'm saying? People just discourage me so much. I had to see some honesty, some innocence, you know? So we drove all that extra way just so I could hug them little niggas, for real.
I know.
You know? Then I ain't gonna lie to you, man. You know, I just lost my mama. Yesterday was the first Mother's Day without my mama. And today, my brother's birthday. Got a lot of shit on my mind. But what I'm gonna do is I just got them hugs and got refueled, you heard me? For real. And I'm about to go to New Orleans and raise hell.
He asked a question, I said I agree with him. I didn't yell, I didn't cuss, nothing. She jumped up and felt like she needed to go call the police. That's ridiculous. All right,
well, we're gonna let the Spanish speaking lady help the Spanish speaking lady.
Mm-hmm.
The English speaking lady is gonna help the English speaking
but what,
lady.
But what I wanted to express to you, I understood you from the get up, Doc. I want you to know, you know me, I've been in here before, we've had mm-hmm. conversations. This is what I want you to know. Why I went this far with it and I'm still recording is because I want to know why can't black people ask questions in the welfare office. All this man did was ask a question. That lady know, the lady right there know, she know we was all in here. That lady didn't have to go call the police on nobody. All that man did was ask a question. And I swear to God on my mama, who is Mama D. You know Mama D? That's my mama. I swear to God, all I said was, I agree with him. And she jumped up and called the police for me. Or, as you say, or him or whoever. But no, nobody did nothing after the police called on him. And that's the society we living in 2017, where a black man can't ask a question. That man asked a question. He ain't raise his voice. He ain't cuss. He ain't approach nobody. He wasn't threatening nobody,
well,
nothing.
Let me ask you a question. Are you going to allow the process to continue
on? I didn't stop the process. Yeah, I didn't stop the process. But I got enough sense to know that how they handle him is how they going to handle me, too.
They're going to handle his business. He's going to handle his business. You're going to handle
I just wanted to tell you she puts you in that water. Ask
I'm
the witnesses.
The water,
I'm just saying. But you know what? Let me tell you what's so crazy about that statement you just made. Because what are you swimming for? That's what I'm trying to get you to see. She sent you in that water. That's what I'm telling you.
Well, I'm not particularly understanding the slang you're trying to
What I'm saying is, man, you here to uphold the law, right? You've taken an oath.
All we're trying to do is have peace so these people can take care of their business and get out.
And we had peace. I'm trying to let you know where.
Had and have is two
I'm letting you know where it went loose at.
Nobody not being
yeah.
Doing
yeah. That. I'm letting you know where it went awry. Now you're telling me that you don't want me to communicate to you what really happened.
I didn't tell you that.
Okay, well, I'm trying to tell you what really happened while the witnesses are still here. That lady, this man, that lady, this lady.
Everybody agrees to be calm and get their business taken care of.
Was I ever uncalm, ma'am? Somebody in here tell me when I was uncalm. That's the point
you
I'm trying to make.
Let these do
I ain't moved
do
out my seat since I've been here, officer. No. That's what I'm trying to tell you.
Are you going
I swear to God, ask him.
For the process to
Yeah. And I'm also going to play this tape for her supervisor, since you don't want to hear what I'm trying to tell you just happened.
I didn't hear what you tried to say.
All right.
Yep, black people ain't nothing nice. All of
us. We can't ask no questions.
No questions.
At all.
Now look, I ain't gonna let you sit back here and keep it up here. Now you're saying what you have to say. Everybody that heard you, everybody agree with you. That should be it, right?
Was that me talking to you, or was that him talking to you?
Whoever said.
That's what I'm just saying.
Well, I tell you what.
That wasn't even me talking to you, man.
You wanna know how quiet it's really about to be back here? Both of y'all gonna end up leaving.
I got on my video that I wasn't even talking to you, man. That wasn't me talking to you. That wasn't even me talking to you.
I don't care what's
but you back over here on me, and that wasn't even me talking.
It's coming from here.
That wasn't even me talking to you.
I'm not saying nothing else.
Let it go, man. Come on, just wrap it up.
That's it. Let it go. It's David. Let it alone. Your video don't move me, bro. That don't scare me.
I'm not trying to scare you. I'm trying to protect myself, homie.
Protect yourself from what?
I'm in fear of my life.
We sometimes overlook the fact that what we need to be doing is really out of necessity. Like, that's what fuels me. Are you not aggravated when you meet the racist glass ceiling or the double standard block to your liberty, your freedom, your justice, what you're trying to achieve, your happiness? Okay, so when do we express that? And when is it fair to do so? 10 states have already made it illegal to peacefully protest.
Peacefully protest.
You hear what I'm telling you?
Yeah.
So we're about to not be able to say nothing.
Exactly. Just
and
shut up.
If that if we allow that to take place while we're under a clearly second class citizenry, oh.
We under attack, like Pac said.
Yeah.
You feel what I'm saying? Speaking of the states and those things, last year in 2017, you ran in the mayoral race for New Orleans. My first question is why? Because why would you put yourself out there like that?
Well, first of all, why would I put myself out there? Let me tell you why I would put myself out there. Because
which is not a bad thing.
I'm going to tell you why I would put myself out there. Because their tact and their etiquette enslave us in a game of ever-changing rules dictated and mitigated by them.
Mm-hmm.
Meaning, show me he who is more fit to control my environment and dictate for my seas than me. I don't see him out here. I don't see the squeaky clean man nowhere. I see human men, and I see myself as a very good example or paradigm for what we need to change the ills in our environment.
I mean, if you just look at the per capita income, medium two-house family in America that's white, the average income is $87,000, man. For black people, it dropped all the way down to $28,000.
Jesus.
It's the average. What kind of shit that is? They just, you know.
And that's just average with a man, woman, and child. Not to mention if you're a single mother, single father.
Well, see, this is the thing. I'm going to tell you, though. You're right. That's average with the, you know, married, man, woman, and child. But if you look at that even, you would notice that, you know, those figures are skewed by rich people, you know, singers and whatnot. It's lower than that. You take out, you know, Bill Cosby and his wife. You take out, you know,
the Oprahs and
Beyonce.
Yeah,
and, you know, well, she's not married, but you take out Beyonce and her husband and all them people that do skew those statistics, and you'll see that, man, black people out here surviving off of $4,000-$5,000 a year. I'm telling you, I've had a couple years of my life where I did that when I was in college. So it can't happen. You nigga can't live off, you know. They can live off, you know, minimal.
Because we gonna make it happen.
Well, there's some animosity. A lot of people in the city, not a lot, it's very limited few. I don't want to put myself out there negatively, but it's a couple people in the city, black people, that I went to them when I knew they were starving. Said, man, I got $100 an hour for you, $75 an hour, whatever the job was. They don't have no job. The lights was off when I was talking to two of them. And they still asking me, well, how much I could, that's all I could get? I'm like, wait a minute, where else? You don't gotta take no drug test.
You want to get $100 off, all you got to do is sign a W-9. I'm going to pay you cash at the gig. Like, come on, man.
These are my notes I was taking today. So I had to get it all in my planner so when I ride, I can have everything I need with me.
Mm-hmm. We ain't gonna give the people all your secrets though.
I mean, I want the people to understand that there has been no functional, successful man ever that
who didn't write they stuff down straight
that's
up.
That's what you gotta do.
Mm-hmm. And, you know, Giza, like, we didn't just go to Cairo, Egypt. We went everywhere around there. We saw the pyramids of Giza on this trip.
Mm-hmm.
And that was amazing, too, because, like, TV, the video camera and all that, it can't do justice. You have to go see some things.
Right.
And the pyramids are one of the things you have to see that were built by man. But all natural things totally blow away anything man ever made, you know? Like, Niagara Falls.
Mm-hmm.
If you go ride the Maid of the Mist.
I've been there, Niagara Falls, when I was like 5 or 6.
Did you ride the boat though?
Ooh, it's a vague memory.
I'll tell you this,
I have to go back now.
That's not an average experience.
Right.
Like, niggas don't never want to think, don't want reason. Niggas just want their way.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I don't be wanting my way. I be trying to, like, 50-50 with my niggas, you feel me?
Mm-hmm.
Whatever I'm asking you for, I will give you.
Right.
That's the first precursor. I don't never ask a nigga for nothing. I would, like, if I wouldn't loan you $100, I wouldn't ask you to loan me $100. I swear, that's how I really rock.
But everybody, you know, they wrote the youth off, but the youth is a product of the environment. So I don't get that. You can't condemn the youth without saying you lousy too.
Right. I was at the emergency room the other night with my son. The other day, and it was a young man in there, and he was just a clown, just a straight clown, and everybody looking at him like, so I said, how you doing? And so he came over there about me, and Rosa, my daughter, says, you always sticking your foot in your mouth. I said, that's okay. I said, you doing okay today? He said, I'm fine. And then he rapped for me, and he did all kinds of stuff, you know, just staying in that little section because I gave him some attention. And at the end, when we was getting ready to go, I said, now what's your name? And he told me, he said, I'm from Kansas. I said, what part of Kansas? He said, just on the northeast end. I said, well, have you ever been to Miss Orr's Cafe? He said, I thought that was you, Miss Orr. You know, he said, I thought that was you. He said, I should have known it because you always came downtown with everybody.
But you know what's so funny? I ain't gonna lie. I was guilty of it before with my mother.
Uh-huh.
But, you know, I found that I started telling young people and my children, well, y'all think I just walked out here 40-something years old? You know what I'm saying? And so, Rosie should have known that you were to this
room. Right. Yeah. I mean, because, you know,
I did the same thing to my mama. That's why I started with that.
Uh-huh, everybody looked at it crazy.
Once I had to start telling my children, look, I know what I'm doing.
Uh-huh.
And then,
come to find out,
he used to have all of us. But wait, hold up. And then come to show you, God gave Rosie her lesson because the man knew you. Like, as if you need to tell her that you've known out here. You feel me? Get my point.
Everybody just need a little attention every now and then.
Yeah. Yeah. Everybody needs more than just a little attention every now and then.
Thank you.
I've
had muscle cancer for as long as I can
do. Yes, ma'am.
That's
The dog whisperer used to always walk in the house and tell the people, first thing, there's something about your vibration that has to be adjusted to affect the dog's vibration. And so, let me give it to you in layman. Our kids, man, I see that they about to raise up and start dying. gonna start fighting it because they see we won't fight it. And they don't respect us because they know that we ain't trying.
That's heavy.